Sarah Martin will be her evaluator. Sarah, tell us about her speech.
Good morning, y'all. That was what an awesome speech to follow. It made me feel extra thankful to be part of this group. And Carol is one of our newer members, part of this group. So thankful you joined this group. She is going to be speaking on the dynamic leadership path. Y'all want to lean into this title called Willing to Kill If Necessary. Very curious, 5 to 7 minutes.
Sarah. So Carol has worked as a business consultant for franchise owners for 15 years with a background in finance, human resources, operations, marketing, sales. She enjoys no 2 days are the same in that franchise world. She explains coaching new owners to become successful business owners is a very rewarding job. Help me welcome Carol as she shares with us Willing to Kill, Y'all, If Necessary.
Thank you, Mr. Toastmaster. Good morning, y'all. Being Southern, that word's going to roll right off my tongue. Willing to kill if necessary. I'm sure that piqued your interest. The connotation alone may have you wondering, where's the speech going to take me and will I be an accessory after the fact? Well, my friends, we're talking about innovative leadership style. Let's break it down. Innovative is an adjective. Of a product or idea, innovative is featuring new methods, advanced and original. Of a person, innovative is introducing new ideas, original and creative in thinking. Leadership is a noun, the action of leading a group of people or an organization. Style is also a noun, the manner of doing something. So let's talk about some of the qualities of an innovative leader. They display excellent strategic vision. They can vividly describe the vision of their future. Let me give you an example. She excelled at painting of a clear picture of our destination while we worked to figure out how to get there. An innovative leader has a strong customer focus. What is interesting to the customer becomes fascinating for these individuals. They seek to get inside the customer's mind by asking incessant questions about their needs and their wants. Innovative leaders create a climate of reciprocal trust. Innovation often requires a level of risk, and not all innovative ideas are successful. These highly innovative leaders initially are warm, collaborative relationships with innovators who work for them. Colleagues know that an innovative leader would always cover their back and never throw them under the bus if something went wrong. Team members are never punished for making honest mistakes. Innovative leaders display fearless loyalty to doing what's right for the organization and the customer. Pleasing a boss or some other higher level executive always takes a back seat to doing the right thing for the project or the company. Guilty. Innovative leaders put their faith in the culture that magnifies upward communication. They believe that the best and most innovative ideas bubble up from underneath. They strive to create a culture that uncorks good ideas from the first level of the organization. They often describe as projecting optimism, full of energy, and also receptive to new ideas. Innovative leaders are persuasive. They are highly effective of getting others to accept good ideas. Not by pushing or forcing their ideas on their teams, they present the ideas with enthusiasm and conviction. They excel at setting stretch goals. These goals require the team to go far beyond just working hard. It requires them to find new ways to achieve high goals. They emphasize speed. Innovative leaders believe the speed scraped off the barnacles off the hull of the boat. Experiments and rapid prototypes are preferred over lengthy studies by large communities. Let's dig right into the meat and potatoes, right? They are candid in their communication. By providing honest and at sometimes blunt feedback, team members feel that they can count on straight answers from their leader. For me, Once again, I've forgotten to put my filter on. They inspire and they motivate. For innovation to exist, they have to feel inspired. And this comes from a clear sense of purpose and meaning in work. Let's look at some differences between an innovative leader and a traditional leader. A traditional leader is guided primarily by the desire for personal success and peripherally by organization success. Whereas an innovative leader is humbly guided by the vision of success based on both performance and the value of the organization's positive impact. Traditional leaders make decisions based on command and control style. The leader has all the answers. In comparison to an innovative leader that will leverage the team for answers as part of the decision-making process. One last comparison is a traditional leader will manage people to perform by being autocratic and controlling, whereas an innovative leader will motivate people to perform through strategic focus, mentoring, and coaching. Lastly, an innovative leader needs to recognize when a project's not working and be willing to kill it, no matter how emotionally invested they have to put into it. So, here we are back at the beginning. Thinking about your leadership style, do you tend to lean towards traditional or innovative or another style of leadership altogether? I believe we all carry a few characteristics of many leadership styles, but it's the ability to pull the best traits of each that will define us as great leaders. Thank you, and back to you, Mr. Toastmaster.
All right, great. Thanks, Carol.